may now be seated. Thank you all for being here on this very special day. We are gathered here today in the sight of God and these witnesses to join together Adam and Karim in holy matrimony, which is an honorable estate instituted by God since man and woman first walked the earth. Therefore, it is not to be entered into unadvisedly and lightly, but reverently. It is truly an honor for me to be presiding over this ceremony, and an honor for all of you who are here to witness it. Obviously, these circumstances are slightly unorthodox. Traditionally, these services take place inside of the walls of the church. Fortunately, we serve a God that is ever present in all things, and so he is here wherever those who follow him share his name. And he is present in this moment as surely as if we were in a church. While the commitment begins with the two of you, its effects radiate outward. It touches the lives of your families, your friends, and the communities that you are a part of. When this commitment is seriously made and continuously fulfilled, it leads to the deepest and most rewarding of human relationships. Your relationship will take more than love. It will take trust to know that you want anything but a special person. Dedication to stay open to one another, to learn and grow each day. And faith to go forward together without knowing what the future holds for you both. While love is our natural state of being, these other qualities are not easy to come by. They are a destination and not a journey, or journey and not a destination. Marriage is a give and take between two personalities, a commitment which diminishes neither of you and enhances both of you. Today we are celebrating Adam and Karim's future together, but let me tell you how it all began. In case you didn't know, the internet has come a very long way. Karim and Adam met online in the middle of a worldwide pandemic. Karim was very unsure of the internet and this very strange man that she had met on it. But Adam kept frequently probing into her life, and eventually this led to an exchange of numbers and an almost daily FaceTime relationship. Then came a promise. Karim was living in Spain with her brother when they met. Since there was a travel ban from Europe to the United States, Karim left and went back to Ecuador, where she could use her visa to travel and Adam could go visit her there. And in November, Karim was waiting for Adam to arrive in her hometown. They traveled through the Andes Mountains, finding waterfalls, finding legendary icemen, meeting Karim's parents, and they really connected. Since then, Karim has visited Adam twice, and now here we are. Adam has asked for the honor of being Karim's husband and continuing their story together. And all of this is incredibly sweet and touching, but these words and stories do not do justice to the love that these two individuals feel for one another. They both care deeply and passionately for each other. They protect each other. They make each other laugh. They think outside of themselves. Time magically seems to both fly and slow down when they are together. They help each other in ways that are obvious and sometimes unnoticed, but always appreciated. And now I will share with you a brief scripture that means a great deal to the couple. Ecclesiastes chapter 4, verse 7 through 12. Again, I saw something meaningless under the sun. There was a man all alone. He had neither son nor brother. There was no end to his toil, yet his eyes were not content with his wealth. For whom am I tolling, he asked, and why am I depriving myself of enjoyment? This too is meaningless, a miserable business. Two are better than one, because they have good return for their labor. If either of them falls down, one can help the other up. But pity anyone who falls and has no one to help them up. Also, if two lie down together, they will keep warm. How can one keep warm alone? Though one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves, and a cord of three strands is not quickly broken. And now, Karim's cousin, Gabriel, would like to share a brief word.
Buenas tardes. Good afternoon. We planned it like 2 minutes ago, we're sorry. Vemos tres cuerdas.
We see three cords broke.
Acabo de leer que está en este capítulo 4, verso 2. Habla de tres.
It talks about three.
Esta va a representar a Karen en este día.
This one represents Karen in this day.
Te va a representar a Adam.
This one represents Adam today.
Y la más importante.
And the most important.
Esta representa a Dios.
This one represents God.
Cuando Dios.
When God.
Está en el centro de un matrimonio.
In the middle of a marriage.
Todo funciona bien.
Everything functions well.
Créanme. Que si Dios está en sus vidas.
God is in your lives.
Todo va a salir bien.
Everything will turn out good.
Y ustedes van a ver.
And you guys will see.
Como Dios bendice sus vidas.
How God blesses your lives.
Y todo lo que hay.
And everything that you do.
Recuerden.
Remember.
Sin Dios.
Without God.
No somos nada.
We are nothing.
Y no somos nada.
And we are no one.
Pero con Dios.
But with God.
Podemos estar unidos.
We can be united.
Como estas tres cuerdas.
Like those three cords.
Que Dios los bendiga.
God bless you.
I love you.
Loves you.
Y yo sé que todo va a marchar bien.
And we know that everything is going to go just fine.
Thank you very much. We can now go to the court. Sorry. Chosen to braid three strands together into a single cord. Each strand is a significant unit. The white strand represents God and His majesty. The blue strand represents Adam and his life. The teal strand represents Karim and her life. In braiding these three strands together, the couple have demonstrated that their marriage is more than a joining of two lives together. It is unity with God as well. They have chosen to allow God to be at the center of their marriage, woven into every aspect of it. The braiding of the three strands demonstrates how Karim and Adam are joined in marriage. Each strand holds a special meaning. The white strand symbolizes that the Lord Jesus has been invited by Karim and Adam to the position of authority in his marriage relationship. The blue strand represents Adam. The majesty of the groom is represented in blue, as the groom loves Karim and submits himself to the Lord. The Lord in turn will demonstrate his great love in the marriage relationship. The teal strand represents the bride. Having been cleansed by the salvation of Christ, the purity of the bride is represented in teal. As Karim honors Adam and submits herself to the Lord in turn will nurture and strengthen the marriage relationship. Ecclesiastes chapter 4:12 reads, though one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves. A cord of three strands is not quickly broken. Today, Karim and Adam have been woven together by God as one into marriage. We are gathered here today to join Karim and Adam in the union of marriage. The This contract is not to be entered into lightly, but thoughtfully and seriously, and with the deep realization of its obligations and responsibilities. It is a commitment made not just to one another, but to God. It is the most treasured of commitments. I now ask Adam to read his vows.
Hope everybody can hear me. My love, Karim, Kareem, Karen, Giovanna, I never heard your name before. It was so unique. I was not sure how to pronounce it. In the beginning when we were meeting each other. So I called you Giovanna, so you would not block me. I knew when I saw you for the first time, I could not mess this up. As of today, I have the honor of calling you my wife. Over the past 9 months, we have used technology, airplanes, snail mail, and our visas to bring us together. Opposite time zones, staying awake, going to bed late, we never missed a day. Today, I'm grateful and privileged to have our family and friends cross oceans and mountains and witness this blessed moment in our lives that we will always remember. When I visited you in Ecuador, you told me that you feared heights, yet you rode the sky cart over the canyon, and you jumped on the swing while I was not looking. You told me that you hated the cold, but you put on layers to climb Mount Chimborazo. You told me you hated to fly, yet you still fly to me. In essence, putting your fears aside for us. This has impacted my love for you. It shows me how selfless you are, that you are willing to take risk and adventure. And in this commitment, we will need both. In January 2020, while still oceans away, you asked for a commitment, one I would highlight as a lasting part of our story. This commitment was different. It was real. It spoke to me in a way of comfort, strength, and absolute certainty. It has impacted me so much that I would like to share it with our family. It says, we promise to be honest, faithful, be a team, to be there for one another. You ask that we promise to ask for forgiveness and learn. We will make time for one another. And you said, I will fight for you when you want to give up. I will pick you up when you are falling down, and I will give you my smile when it's hard to find yours. And my favorite, to take care of each other when we're old, senile, and smelly. Lastly, to love each other unconditionally. Today, you and I become one. Karim, I promise to love you, to be kind and honor our marriage. I promise to be patient and slow to anger. I promise to admit fault and find humility. I promise to never keep score and to always put God and our family first.
Adam, my love, my best friend, my confidant, my companion. I confess that I have always wanted a love like you. I fell in love with you because it was not in my ear that you whispered to me, but in my heart. It was not my lips that you kissed, but my soul. It fills me with emotion to know that I will go with you until the end of the road. I know that there will be many moments of happiness, but we also cross deserts, storms, moments where love mutates.
Pointless.
The flame seems to be disappearing. We will forget maybe why we started. But it's worth it to go all the way together. Reconquering each other 31 times a month. And most important of all, putting God in the equation. Love comes in different packages, flavors, and shades. Love knows no stereotypes, and much less of classes or races. Love destroys all chains and glues all that is broken. And without fear of being wrong, I know that love generates and needs commitment. Love demands sacrifice, loss, meekness, and supremacy. In love, there are facts, consequences, and rules. Love is not an emotion or a feeling. It is a decision, maybe imperfect. But true love, perfect, it over time. I want you to know that it doesn't matter how high or low a home is. It doesn't matter how wide or narrow our room is, as long as we can see each other's eyes. I know that infinity fits in our gaze is enough. Today I join my life to yours. Not only as your wife, but as your friend, your lover, and confidant. I promise to always be by your side. I'm sorry. To be together, a home full of love.
And Adam, do you take Karim to be your wife? Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect her, forsaking all others and holding only unto her forevermore?
I do.
And Karim, do you take Adam to be your husband? Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect him, forsaking all others and holding only unto him forevermore? Now grab the rings. The couple will now exchange rings as a symbol of love and commitment to each other. Rings are a precious metal. They are also made more precious by your wearing them. Your wedding rings are special. They enhance who you are. They mark a beginning of your journey together. Your wedding ring is a circle, a symbol of love never ending that you have just vowed to one another. Adam, please place the ring on Karim's left hand and repeat after me. As a sign of my love,
as a sign of my love,
that I have chosen you,
that I have chosen you,
above all else,
above all else,
with this ring I thee wed.
With this ring I thee wed.
And Karim, please place the ring on Adam's left hand and repeat after me. As a sign of my love,
as a sign of my love,
that I have chosen you,
that I chosen you,
above all else,
above
with this ring I thee wed.
I?
With this ring I thee wed. To make this relationship work, it will take love. Continue to date each other. Take time to show that your love and marriage grow stronger with time. It will take trust to know in your heart that you truly want what is best for one another. It will take dedication to stay open to one another, always learning. And it will take loyalty to go forth, not knowing exactly what the future will bring. And it will take commitment to hold true to the journey you are both pledged to today. And now, by the power vested in me, by the state of Virginia and God, it is my honor and delight to declare you married. Go forth and love one another each day to the fullest. You may seal this declaration with a kiss.
Bravo!
Y a los novios.
Extraordinary is even more than anyone that you adore can love.
To
you is more than just a game for two.
Two in love can make it. Take my heart and please don't break it. Love was made for me.
Open your picture, I'm sorry.
It's fine.
It's for the only one I see. He is very, very extraordinary. He is even more than anyone that you adore can love.
Here's
all that I can give to you. Love is more than just a game for two.
Perfecto.
Take my heart and please don't bring it.
Perfecto.
Love was made for me and
you. Que salga ya.
Love was made
for me and you.
Love was made for me.